Hi guys, and welcome to episode 6 of Becoming Undeniable. You are going to see my show day vlog, what happens on show day, what happened to my face on show day, and of course ignore my lips throughout this entire vlog. I did realise how bad that lip filler looked and I did get it all removed, but I apologise. My lips look horrendous, I know. We are literally 3 hours away from getting on a plane. As you would have seen in the video before, we've dropped Loki Blue and Tickles off to Pettsville, where they will be having a little mini holiday for the week. I've just finished doing some client work. I've just also got out of the shower. I've packed my stuff for the show and I am pretty much ready to go. If there's one thing that I'm looking forward to, it's probably having the spray tan. I do not look like I live in Dubai. Like, I am so ridiculously, disgustingly pale. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to having a spray tan and actually looking like I live in a hot country, because I'm just so pale. The craziest thing is, like, when you're getting ready for a show, you spend all of these months of your life like dedicated to this one goal, and to now finally say that our goal is we'll both be competing at the weekend, it's quite a surreal feeling. Like today, obviously I was in the gym and that was our last gym session at Binos before we leave and fly. So yeah, it's kind of a really strange feeling, but again, I'm really excited. I'm so grateful to be able to prep. Prep has not been an easy ride in the past. I started my fitness journey again as soon as I had the all clear. Obviously, some of you might know, some of you don't know, I was suffering with BII, where both of my implants had ruptured. So in December last year, I went and had surgery and I had both of them taken out. This meant, you know, I couldn't train for 3 months, so I was pretty much bed bound. The only thing I was doing was taking Loki for a walk along our local beach. With this, you know, I lost a lot of muscle. I wasn't training, so I didn't really have an appetite. Again, like, I lost muscle, I lost a lot of size. As soon as I had the all clear, that I could go and train, that's when I signed up with Jamie. And I just honestly, I got to a point in my life where I was like, I didn't feel like I was motivating anyone. And you know, my job as an online coach is to motivate people and inspire people, and I just honestly felt like I really lost that within myself. So that was kind of what the turning point for me was, like, right, get my shit together, let's get myself ready for the photo shoot, and see where we go from there. Fast forward a couple of months, I said to Jamie, I was like, look, do you think I'll be able to step on stage this year? Jamie being Jamie, 100%, was like, yep, let's do it. So it's kind of like, here we are. Obviously, I didn't have an off season, so going into this show, I'm obviously like, oh, what would I look like if I would have had an off season? And what I mean by this is when my body had been in a surplus, whereas my body had been in a deficit for like the last 7 months. So I'm definitely like, I am nervous going into this show. Obviously, it's been about 3-4 years since I've last stepped on stage, so I'm 100% gonna be nervous, but I guess I'm really excited as well. And you know, I think one of the reasons why I'm doing this is I'm doing this for myself. I'm not doing this for anyone else. I'm not doing it for social media. I am literally doing this to myself to prove a point that I can get in shape. And you know, I really wanted to know if I still love the sport. You know, bodybuilding is not just a quick, oh, let's prep for like 3 weeks. Like, you've really got to go, you've got to put your heart and soul into this. Tom's competing on the Saturday, I will be competing on the Sunday, so the whole of the Saturday is all going to be about Tom. I'm going to be trying to vlog him as much as we can, and then obviously on the Sunday, Tom's terrible with the camera, but I'm going to make sure he tries to vlog most of my day, so you can see, like, behind the scenes, see what it takes, and just see what happens, you know, on show day. I've just finished talking to some clients, I've designed some new plans, and I'm going to tidy up the apartment. Just so it's just looking a bit fresh, the kitchens, we've been cooking chicken, shock. So I'm just gonna do a bit of tidying up and then we're gonna call an Uber and we're gonna head to Dubai Airport. So what cryotherapy actually does is you get into a chamber and it's absolutely freezing cold. The reason why we're doing this is just to reduce any inflammation in our body. We are catching a flight tomorrow for the show, which will be on Saturday and Sunday. So we just really wanna try and get as much inflammation out of our body as we can. Quite a lot of our friends have done this and really rate it. So.
So our infrared sauna, by the way, is not just a typical sauna. There is an infrared light. It also depends also on what your body needs or what you prefer. This one is LED light vent, okay? So nothing to do, by the way, with tanning, nothing to do with UV. Everything that we have here is for general wellness, of course, and shine. And in regards to our cryotherapy, it's also oxygenated here, okay? So it's very safe, and of course, it's very beneficial for everyone.
We are just getting ready to go in the cryotherapy. Is 7 a.m. and we are about to drop the pets off to Petsville because they are going on holiday before we catch our flight today. Two cats and Lucky. Tom is doing nothing. Lucky knows exactly where we are.
Yeah. That raw food energy lasts about 2-3 days, but other than that, you'll just go on the dry food.
Just after it finishes, just the dry food.
Yeah.
How much does it next for a meal?
Just probably.
Oh, you're gonna have fun. You're gonna have fun. You're going on holiday for a week. Go have fun. Yeah.
Oh. Come on.
Bye. So we have just finished our pre-workout. We're just having a pre-workout. Not a smoothie, pre-workout shake. My brain's not working. We're just about to have a pump session just to carry on depleting the muscles before we catch our flight. Oh yeah, so our pump session at Binos is now done and we will be catching a flight in 3 hours. Six hours to the show, but that was our last session at Binos until we come back. How do you feel?
I feel very happy.
It's quite a surreal feeling. Like we've both lived at Binos for, we've been at Binos for training how many months, it really does become like a second home, because you just feel like you're there. Like, we were there 3 hours a day. We'd take about 45 minutes to get here. So yeah, we've really, majority of the year, we've just been living at Bynos. So for that to be the last session, that was really quite a really nice feeling. But yeah, really excited now. I'm gonna head back, have a post-workout meal, and then I still need to pack. I should do that. We've dropped the pets off. So yeah, we're just gonna head back now and have post-workout. We have made it to our destination. It is about 3:30 in the morning. We've just got to the airport. We're just waiting to be picked up to pick up our rental car. That flight was horrendous. I woke up as I slept funny. My neck was like cramping where I'm like, eh. But we're here, we made it. Woo! After our flight, arrived really early hours of the morning last night. We have just got to our apartment and we're just waiting for Jamie's response, and then we're gonna head to Tesco's and we're gonna get some breakfast and a few bits to obviously carb up. Always start my day, no matter what, with a cup of tea and a coffee. So we have just got back from Tesco's and we have just bought some more essentials. Jam, rice cakes, bananas. I'm gonna be having some salmon, some strawberries, and Tom is over here making his breakfast. Some cream of rice, which we bought from Al's.
Cream of rice, I'm also having some jam.
We're gonna cook up our rice and chicken. So it is Thursday and we are just having some breakfast and we're about to go and check some clients in and do some work. That is really good.
Well.
Okay, so it is day one at our destination. We are just off to the gym to get a pump session. Tom's got his final one today because he's competing on Saturday and I am competing on the Sunday. So my final pump session will be Friday tomorrow. Tom hasn't even turned the car on.
My brain's not working.
So we are just off to a gym called Chili Fitness. Love that. Love a bit of chili.
Rather chilly, isn't
it? It is such a nice temperature. In Dubai, you walk outside and it's just absolutely roasting, but here is beautiful. It's just the right temperature. Okay, so Tom has just finished his pump session and he is over the moon.
Oh yeah, duh.
How are you feeling?
I
still have one more session tomorrow, so we're gonna come back. And we're just back off to Tesco's as there's a few things we need to get. Good morning, guys. So I am 2 days out from my competition. Jamie has sent through my carb up plan, so I'm going to show you what I have for meal one. Meal one of the carb up, I've got 60 grams of cream of rice, 20 grams of peanut butter, one banana, and a spoonful of jam. And with this, I'll be having 60 grams of chicken. And my morning coffee. Okay, so the game plan is we've just had meal one and we're just off to Tom's and mine registration. Tom has to make weight, so it's important we get there nice and early so he doesn't have as much food in his stomach and he's flat. And then afterwards he will be filling up on carbs and I will just be watching like yeah. So after we go to registration, we're gonna head to Aldi. There's also a Tesco's, but I think we're gonna go to Aldi. We already went to Tesco's the other day. And then we're just gonna stock up on muffins. I've got some pineapple in my plan that I need to get and just a few other bits. But yeah, I'm excited. I'll try and vlog when we're at pre-registration so everyone can see sort of what happens when you have your athletes meeting. So we are just at the athletes meeting.
I feel all right, to be fair.
It's quite busy.
It's very busy.
So classic, we've come back to the car and we've got a ticket.
Tradition is.
That is tradition. Every time we go somewhere we always end up with a parking ticket.
Not fucking paying it though.
So the athletes meeting is now done. It's really nice in there. I thought it was very organised. They give you like a little goodie bag, you go pay for your photos and you just confirm everything. We're just gonna head back now and we're heading
right.
Someone just decided to cross the road.
It was a zebra cross on off.
So we're just heading now to Aldi and we're just going to get a few more things that we need in our diet. Tom is also at the venue today, so I'm going to meet him there. He's going to be on stage probably about between 10 and 12, so I've got to make sure I get to the venue so I don't miss him. Okay, so small crisis. I was washing my hair and my nail decided that it would just ping off. Like, I'm not even surprised anymore. So we are just at the IFBB show in Hungary. I'm just waiting for Tom to come on. He's gonna be doing quite a few categories, so I'm keeping an eye out so I can film his whole entire routine. Okay, pose. Gone on stage and he looks fucking sick. Okay, so my first layer is tan, is done. I'm gonna head back to the car and we're gonna head back home. I'll be back here at 7 a.m. tomorrow for my show day. Good morning guys, it is officially my show day. The time is 5:56 and we are just about to take my morning photo condition, send it to Jamie and he's gonna send through my plan of what he wants me to eat today. Okay, so for my meal one, on show day I've got 200 milliliters of water in my coffee, 50 grams of rice cakes, so I'm allowed 1 tablespoon of jam, a cookie, and 100 grams of salmon.
Okay, spray tan is now done. I am about to get my makeup done. Jewelry is on.
Like a circle that floats around me, keeping me safe and sound. And when I fall, you've tied a rope to me. You're blessing me every day. I was down with an illusion, like a sparrow with broken wings. But now I shine with your reflection on me. I'm getting back up on my feet. That you showed up was written in my palm. You are a statement, explode like a bomb. I get to push myself to victory. You make me winner. You cut me loose and set me free. You make me win in every way. You showed me how to spread my wings. Yes, I'm the winner.
Okay, so I've also got my stage shots back from the show that I did in Budapest. So I'm just going to go over what my personal thoughts are of competing and what I need to work on, and was I happy with the feedback? As you guys would have seen, my makeup was fucking horrendous. Looking back, your foundation is meant to be like a shade darker than your neck. My foundation that woman, the makeup artist, put on me was darker than my actual tan. I got catfished into having the worst makeup artist in Budapest. Some could argue it looked nice, but personally, I absolutely hated it. Looking back at it, I thought I looked like a drag queen. And as soon as I had my makeup done, I remember I was sitting on the floor backstage and I had this mirror. And I just kept looking at myself going, it doesn't look like me. Like, I look so different, but not in a good way. I thought I looked different in a really bad way. It was just like so orange. My face looked so dirty and I had like a line here. She'd managed to get all like foundation in my hair, so I tried to like scrub it out, and I looked an absolute mess. And then to top it all, I had some like hideous silver eyeshadow. And my friend who I messaged at the time was like, wipe it off, start again. And before I could do this, they literally called my number and I had to go on stage. So I had no time to sort this makeup out. So looking back, I'm either hands down gonna do my makeup myself,
Or find a trusted makeup artist that I trust with my life, because I looked horrendous on show day. And the thing is, when you're marked on your overall presentation and your makeup, you know, I didn't feel as confident. I didn't feel as good because I knew I looked like a drag queen. So here's a tip for everyone. Do not get catfished into a makeup artist. Have a picture ready and say, look, this is what I want to look like. Maybe do a bit of research on the makeup artists in that area and have a look on Instagram, like look at their work. Because I wish if I knew I had that person, I would have been like, absolutely fucking not, give me someone else. But yeah, I look back at it now and I just laugh and think, what the fuck happened to my face? So I was very happy with my back shot. I thought my glutes and hamstrings come in perfectly. I had a very visible tie-in, which I was so, so, so happy with. My feedback from the judges were my hamstrings needed to be a bit more conditioned and my glutes needed to be fuller. My delts were slightly soft, so next time they need to come in a bit harder. Which is, yeah, quite fair. I do agree with that. You guys are also going to notice I had my lip filler taken out. That was another mistake. You know, at the time, I thought it looked really good. But as, you know, the days and the weeks went on, I noticed my lip started to, like, my lip started to do this. So when I was smiling, like, you couldn't see any of my teeth. And I was like, what is the point? Like, that's not what lip fillers meant to do. Like, I'm all about enhancing your natural beauty and, like, doing things to enhance it. But when it actually makes it look worse, I feel like that's when you need your friends, your partners to say, like, stop doing that. Just stop. So, yeah, I had my lip filler taken out and I smile and you can see about 10 teeth again. I like my smile. I don't want to hide my smile. So that's why I got my lip filler removed. If I get tempted to put lip filler in my lip again, someone stop me. Someone say to me, don't. Just put me on a lip filler bag.
Hey guys, I hoped you liked my show day vlog and I will see you in the next episode.